After login, go to the profile page and select Rackspace under Providers. Give a unique account name. Click on Create. Go to End Tier page. Select Rackspace Sample Template. Give a unique name to the system and scroll down the template. In the Rackspace account tag, enter your Rackspace username. Click Deploy System. Go to the deployed system. Click on Definition tab. Scroll down. Let's increase the number of servers to 2. Click on Update System to save changes. In this system, we have only one tier. We have 3 actions, one for monitoring, one for Java installation, and one for deploying and starting Jira application. In addition, there are 3 events in this system, one for recovery, one for scaling up, and one for scaling down. For editing the system definition, please refer the N-tier documentation. Go to the monitoring page. Click on Configure System Event. Select the system and select Group for defining threshold. Select the event name. The event drop-down list is populated from the events defined in the system definition file. Since we want the event to be triggered in case any server in the group fails, select Non-Aggregate Event Type. Select Ping for failure threshold. Check the alert box for email notification. After defining the trigger for the event, go to the End Tier page and start the system. You can go to the Log tab to check the status of deployment. The system we are deploying provisions the servers, installs monitoring agents, installs Java, and then installs and starts the Jira issue tracking software. The infrastructure, middleware, and application is deployed with a single click. After the system is fully deployed, let's check if application is running properly. You can connect to the servers over SSH or copy files using SFTP. Now let's test the autopilot functionality by deleting one server. Within 90 seconds, IMOD will auto-detect the failure and execute the recovery workflow. Let's validate the recovery. Wow! Everything is recovered to the original state.